a low intensity aerobic workout. So let's get started. Placing the heels underneath the hips, soften the knees, lifting and lengthening into the spine. A big shoulder roll to draw the shoulders up, back and down. Relax the arms, engaging to the core. Our first move is an easy step touch. Just a little movement from side to side. So we're gradually going to raise the heart rate and increase the rate of our breathing. Same move, but a little bigger. Squat stick, down and up, down and up. So we're starting to warm up the legs a little more. From here, we can add some arms, reach and pull. Then it's a hamstring curl. Heel to bum. Start to feel your hamstrings warming up. Should still be feeling pretty good here. Now we're going to take four marches forwards. Left knee, left the heel. Easy start. Last time, direction change to the corner. Same move, but we're just taking it on an angle. Release the heel to change direction. Last time. Now it's a knee repeater, tap repeater. So bend into the back knee and shoot your front leg back. You can have a reach and pull with the arms. Four more. Change sides. So drop into the back leg, knee over the middle of the front. Chest is up, shoulders are back and down. Four, three, squat step. Reach. Maybe you can sink just a little deeper now into this squat step. You can even add a reach up. Hamstring curl. Now with the arms overhead, you might be breathing just a little heavier. That's all good. Four, three, four marches forwards. Try and lift that front knee in line with the hip. So again, we take it on a diagonal. And this time, maybe a little hop to change sides. Squat, down, up, down, up. So let's try and get the weight back and down and into the heels. Double pulse squat and up. So it's quite a quick move up. And it wants to feel that we're popping up like a cork. Now we're going to add some movement. Just a side to side. So we're going to add this move a bit later on. Last time, marching forwards. And back. If you've got room, bigger steps now. Longer strides. On the diagonal. Little hop. Last time. New move. Step and tap. Step, tap. Step, tap. Now we're starting to engage into the outer thigh and the outer hip. Same again. But we're going to try and get lower. Lower into this move. So light tap. Chest up. Last one. Hold for the squat. Down. Up. Down. wide, wider than the shoulders. So we're going to get that bum level with the knees up. Arms. It's a triple pulse squat. 3, 2, 1, to stand tall. Now we push the heels to stand to activate the glutes and the back of the legs. Next time we're going to add a right knee to left. Left. Try and lift the knee at least in line with the hip if you can. 4 more times. Check in with the abs. Engage into the core so the movement is much stronger. Last one. We're going to tap in. We're going to tap back 3 times and lunge. Tap, tap, tap and lunge. 3, 2, 1. So you want to drop that back knee so it's under the hip. 4 more times. Back knee. Under the hip. Front knee. Just over the ankle. Or maybe slightly forward to the middle of the foot. Last time. Single back stepping lunge. Down. Step in. Just that same long stride. And if you can, front thigh parallel with the floor. Next time, we're going to add a knee up. Now, step. You're trying to get the knee up to the chest. Keeping the chest high. 2 more. Then, step, tap. Step, tap, back, back. So we're going to start with the deeper move. Good here. Same thing. Bigger step forward. Bigger step back. Almost ready for this squat again. Last one. Hold it and squat. Down and up. So again, chest up. Weight back and down. And into the heels. A triple pulse. 3, 2, 1. Now we should feel with a triple pulse a little sting coming into the thighs. We're going to add the knee lift. 3, 2, 1. Knee up. Now just check your knees when you squat that the knees don't come any further forward than the middle of the foot. Down. Push up and into your supporting leg. One more. Step in. Tap back. 3, 2, 1. Back to the lunge. You can add some arms. Running arms. But if you prefer, hands on your hips. It really doesn't matter. Just check that front knee alignment again. Go further forward than the middle of the foot. Single time. Down, step, down, step. So we've got that strong upper body. Next time, knee drive. So you're working into the legs, into the hips. Last one. Step and tap. Now to finish this section, you can stay with a step and tap. Keep it low. Or we can add drop squat. Drop squat. Last time. Repeat it. Maybe repeat it. Straight in. You're going to add a reach and pull. Reach and pull. Same thing. Other side. Try and get low into that back leg. Shoot the front leg back long. New move. Double pulse squat. Just like we did in the warm up. Not much time to get the range, so as much as you can. Then we add the movement. Arms. Diagonal lunge. Same side. Long step forward. Front knee over the middle of the foot. Same move. Doing bigger. Adding the arms. Down. Try and square off your hips. Okay. That's one. Repeat it. Drive the knee up. Maybe in line with the hip. With the arms. Reach. Pull. Same move. Other side. Can you get that front leg going back a little further? If you need to take out the arms, the running arms is good. Double pulse. Up. Push through the heels. Engage into the back of the legs. Knees out. Now the movement. Down. Down. Up. It's like you're trying to touch the ceiling. Diagonal lunge. Start with the alignment of the knee. And now the push back. Engage. Add the arms. And see if you can go further. One more round. Repeat to knee. Let that bigger move now. Muscles are warm. Heart rate is up. Four more. Change sides. Just checking in with the shoulders. Backing down. The knees lifting up. In line with the hip. Double squat pulse. Now this is a bit like a finale. So you can choose what you need to do. Then we have to move it. Up. And if you wish, propulsion. Stay with this. Double pulse. We'll go without propulsion. Diagonal lunge. Right to the left. We are straight in with the big version of the move. Push off. Two steps across. Heel up. Hamstring curl. Settle your breathing. Last time. Just squat. Down. start the squat combination, but we need enough room to come forward as well. Next time, add the knee. Alternate. Knee lifts. Just like we did, the triple pulse. Push up through your supporting leg. Stay with this move. Down, up, down, up. So there's a little bit of stability at the top. So you need to engage into the core. Now, we're going to step forward. Calf raise. Step. March back. 8 times. Triple pulse squat. 3, 2. Come forward again. Reach. March. Triple pulse squat. 2 steps across. Can we add some down and up now? And try and get the heel all the way to the bar. Squat, knee raise. Finding the range, bum, level with the knees. This move, single time. Now what we need is we need to stay like a sumo wrestler. Nice and low. Ready for battle? Maybe. Step, calf raise. Maybe reach a little higher by bending the knees. Then march, knees up. If you wish. 2. Again. Bend the knees as you step forward. And march. Triple pulse. 2 steps. Now because we are reaching the end of the aerobic section, you have an option here. Only if you want it, you can add a gallop. So a little spring. Anytime you need to, back to the double step. Squat, knee raise. To practice for the sumo move, feet wide. Drop deeper if you can. Same move, single time. Chest is lifted. Core is engaged. Strong athletic arms. Step, calf raise. Bend knees. March back. Triple pulse. Step, calf raise. Option, little jump. March back. Triple pulse squat. Last time, 2 steps across. Gallop. 2 minutes. Then we start to cool down. Squat, knee raise. Prime your body. Bum. Level with the knees, feet wide. Same time. And if you wish, a little spring in your step. Anything is optional. Step calf raise. Add a jump. Tall bar heel landing. Jog or march. Triple pulse. one more time. Jog on arch. Triple pulse. Step touch. Whew. Hopefully, your heart rate lifted, you got warmer, and you increased the rate of your breathing. We just got a little bit fitter. Stay with us. And maybe, like me, just a little film of sweat. Scared away from your calories, tone and condition our legs. We're going to go back to the diagonal lunge, alternate side. Now, for about 4 minutes, we're going to work the core and the triceps and the shoulders. Fold this one over. Now, come down into a tricep push-up position. So that's knees, box, 3/4, or full. You can choose. So hands on your shoulders, drop down, and slowly up. So the elbows are in. You should feel your upper arms just gripping the side of your body. Now we've got a combination. Tricep push-up, rotating plank. Turn your body as one unit. Tricep push-up, rotating plank, core is engaged. Two more times, here's your option. Box, with a rotation here. So we've got one more. You choose, rotating plank. Now hold the plank. You can go back to your knees and we'll stay on your toes. Curl into the knees, engage into the core, push the heels away, and then come up in your own way or strongly loaded squat. Side lunge. So one more phase of work. We're staying strong. Now hold it over this side. Hold the lunge. Turn, come safely down onto your knees. And your options, box, 3/4. Full tricep push-up. If you're feeling super strong, let's start the tricep push-up this side. Down, down. Now just check your chest isn't coming too deep. So it's just coming to about elbow height. Back is staying long. Combination, tricep push-up, rotating plank, point to the ceiling, tricep push-up, rotating plank. Two more if you can, stop if you need to. But we're always just a little bit stronger than we think we are. Now hold the plank, 30 seconds. Last little bit of effort. Shoulders away from the ears, spread the fingers, push into the hands. Then release. Step touch. So we're gonna go for a little stretch now. Just a few stretches, mainly for the legs. We're going to start with the feet back hip distance. We're going to lunge side to side, not on the diagonal, side to side. Nice and easy. Little stretch for the inner thigh. Let's hold this one down. Hold. Now, just stretch into the inner thigh, or rest your forearm and left over the top. Draw the shoulders away from the ears. Lift up, switch the feet, and do the same on the other side. So again, align your knee just over the ankle this time. Release, lock the feet in, and then quad stretch. Heel to bump, push the hips. Bring the knee together. So you should feel a stretch down the front of the thigh. Same leg, half a step forward, hamstring stretch, push the hips back. So you want your back long. You're stretching into the back of the thigh on that front leg. Take that leg back. You've got a hip flexor stretch. You're going to tuck the back knee under. You're going to feel that stretch in the front of the hip. And while we're here, why not? Tricep stretch. And then release. Quad stretch, other side. Balance, hold on to something if you need to. Soften your supporting knee now. Maybe push the foot more into the hand. Try and increase that stretch. Bring that leg half a step forward. Push the hips back again. And slide the shoulders away from the ears. Think about that long spine. You can lift the toe, some people prefer to, or just keep the foot down. Go back. Tuck the hip. Drop the back knee. Make sure you find that stretch in front of the hip. And then add on. Tricep. Release. Let's roll the shoulders and open up the chest. Give ourselves space to breathe now. And then from here, cross the palms, tuck the chin. And just lift the shoulders up to the ears. One more stretch on each side. Right leg behind. Right arm comes up and over. Try and push the hips away. Try to find that length all the way down the side of the body. Then change sides. Just release. Step tucked again. Thanks very much for your time, your effort and your energy today. And of course, your honest, well-earned sweat. And I will see you soon. Have a great day.